Divya Parashar. At 33, she's a successful psychologist who leads a typical urban Indian 24/7 lifestyle. On most days, she manages to squeeze out some time for exercise and then it's time to get ready for work. And while most women of her age still grapple to achieve a balance and cope with the mental and physical stress, Divya manages it all like magic.
My work involves working with patients who have primarily spinal cord injuries, but then I do mental health counseling, I work with kids, so working with other people in the team. Then I come and I have to have my morning cup of coffee, and then I get in and then I have my appointments.
Look, for now, you can't imagine she'd ever looked otherwise. But Divya has a different story to tell.
In 99, I went to the US to do my PhD over there. Everything was so cushy over there that very little, I wasn't active, I would say. So gradually, I would think in maybe a course of 4 years, I think I had put on almost about 20, 25 kilos. I thought I was eating right. But before I knew it, I was at 96 kilos, which was the maximum I'd ever been. So I was actually, you know, obese as what the doctor told me.
But a blood test during one of her trips to India revealed much more.
Obesity, one, obviously, the main one. Borderline hypertension, dyslipidemia, insulin resistance.
She's 30 years of age and Divya Parashar was already suffering from a cluster of problems. While individually they are a reason to worry, together they spell disaster. Divya Parashar was diagnosed with metabolic syndrome, a combination of risk factors that almost double your risk of heart disease and stroke. And it's affecting urban Indians like never before.
Take this recent study carried out in the Apollo hospitals in New Delhi as an example. A random test of 906 people who'd walked in for a routine checkup revealed that a shocking 40% of them suffered from metabolic syndrome. None of them knew that they had even one diagnosed disease, while each one suffering from more than three lifestyle disorders. In fact, studies have shown that more number of women suffer from metabolic syndrome than men. Endocrinologist Dr. Amrish Mittal, who conducted the study, says why these figures are so worrying.
40% is a huge, huge number. It means that almost anybody could be at risk. And if you look at just one risk factor, the figure goes up to almost 90%. So if you're looking at risk for heart disease, risk for stroke, risk for developing diabetes, you're sitting on a bomb.
So how do you know if you are at risk of metabolic syndrome? Well, all you need is a simple blood test that reveals these markers.
Classically, metabolic syndrome includes an elevated triglyceride level in the blood, a low good cholesterol, HDL cholesterol in the blood, an increased waist circumference, which for Indians would be about 80 centimeters in men and 90 centimeters in men, a high blood pressure above 130-85, and also elevated fasting glucose of maybe more than 110, which affects insulin resistance.
Worrisome is the fact that each lifestyle disorder that you may have increases the risk of the other. For example, a large waistline has been linked to heart disease and it increases the risk of diabetes by almost 50%. Similarly, diabetes along with high blood pressure can almost double your risk of heart disease.
In Divya's case, like most Indians, the genetics also add up as a risk factor. But experts insist that it cannot be the only reason.
What triggers an actual transformation into the metabolic syndrome is a lifestyle. The genes will just predispose us. And what are these things in the lifestyle? One is lack of exercise. Second is faulty eating habits, high levels of psychosocial stress, and lack of sleep, which adds to all this.
Things have gotten very dangerous, but Divya fought against the problem with dietary changes coupled with a good exercise regimen. And then in a year's time, Divya had turned a new leaf. She had lost 35 kilos.
People have stopped recognizing me, so they don't know who I am.
Her report card showed that all the abnormalities were now within the normal range. But the best was yet to come. Divya was told that she had not only controlled her lifestyle disorders, but she had reversed her condition.
I still can never forget that, and when he wrote reversal of metabolic syndrome, I felt like I was a small kid who got on all A's and had topped the class, and I was grinning from ear to ear.
doctors were also pleasantly surprised.
Divya's case shows clearly that it is not only possible to control metabolic syndrome, but also to bring it back to normal and without any problems, any diseases.
Divya and her husband Narayan are now looking forward to a new life and are planning to start a family.
So things have changed, I mean, in a nutshell, in a big way.
Cases like Divya go on to prove that it is not impossible to manage or in fact resolve your lifestyle disorders. But these lessons are not just for adults. The couch potato lifestyle is taking a toll on kids as well by putting them at risk of typically adult onset diseases.
Arman Talwar is a 14-year-old who loves his PlayStation 3. Television and junk food have been his constant companions. And he dreams to be a guitarist one day, or maybe a football player.
By the way, that's how I broke my arm last week while playing football.
And well, if there's any time left after all this, studies and cramming take over. But Arman didn't see any reason to complain.
Well, after class 10 or, once you just entered it, I mean, everything is about studying. You don't find the time to even go to the loo after you come back from school. So, it's like get home, study, study, study more, and then tuitions.
But there was only one problem.
I started putting on weight at the age of 9. After that, I just gained weight and gained weight. Now, we couldn't find the reason why, but I gained weight. So, till about 14 and a half, I was just gaining weight.
That's what drove Arman and his parents to see nutritionist Ishi Khosla. A few tests revealed that they had a bigger problem at hand. Arman was diagnosed with metabolic syndrome.
His insulin is high, his blood sugar is high, he has what we call impaired fasting. Mm-hmm. His triglycerides are higher, the good cholesterol is low, and this is really not a very happy picture.
Arman is not the only one. A study by endocrinologist Dr. Anup Mishra found that in the last 10 years, the number of kids suffering from metabolic syndrome has gone up from 4.2% to 6.4%. Another recent survey showed that out of 400 kids, 4 were found to be type 2 diabetic and 37 were pre-diabetic.
This is an outcome of his lifestyle. And this is reflecting that he is eating badly, he is not exercising adequately. In fact, he says he's hardly exercising. And this is totally preventable.
And Arman himself tells us the reasons.
It's like I would have Coke, I would have chips, I would snack generally during the day. There was no activity as such, physical activity. So, that led to a lot of weight.
We had never seen this coming. We hadn't even ever thought about it. So I think as parents, it hit us very hard. And that's why we were absolutely committed to, make it work for him and get it under control.
But all this was 3 months ago. Arman was put on a tailor-made diet and a fitness regimen by Ishi.
After Dr. Ishi Khosla, the ingredients in my kitchen changed. Everything. We've been using full salt, we've been using 3 or 4 different types of art. Here are the fruits that I'm supposed to eat. Except for the melons, I'm supposed to eat everything else. But other times, there would be some special brown rice with either some pulses or any kind of a gravy. Or it would be salad.
And here's the good news. For Arman, early diagnosis worked beautifully. With a good diet and physical activity, he has lost 10 kilos in the last 3 months. And all his hormonal problems are well under control.
Now I am 78.2 and I've lost 10 kilos overall in 3 months.